What is up, everybody? This is the video that you've hired to either help you figure out which of these nice little toys you're gonna get for yourself, or to help you understand if you made the right decision on the ones you got or not, because not all tech makes our life better. Some just makes it more complicated. Luckily, wireless earbuds are so delightful. They are just one of the most humane pieces of technology as far as I'm concerned. The way that they enable movement, getting out into the world, but still getting to take in media, having phone calls, conversations, call your dad. They are so delightful when they work well, okay? And I've been testing almost all of the ones that you really need to know about. I definitely have some recommendations for you, okay? I'll link to everything below in the description. Let's get into it. Now, what I'm looking for in particular is the best everyday do everything headphone, like wireless Bluetooth earbud, okay? I don't want something different for listening to music and something different for the gym. I want one thing that does it all, that's pocketable, that has the right battery. You know what I'm saying? Now, you just might want something that's excellent for listening to music. Look no further than these, for example. The Sennheiser Momentums sound super good when you've got a good seal in there, but their microphonics are really bad. So when you're listening to something good and walking, like you can hear your skull rumbling, you can hear the vibration of everything. So they're really only good for sitting and listening. Oh, and their battery drains when you don't use it. Maybe this has been fixed in a firmware or something like that. But they're, you don't see them for a week, you come back, oh, I'm gonna listen to some music, they're dead. Why? Because they just trickle down. Like you have to be charging them all the time. So they're actually really good for sitting and listening, which like I said, just get a pair of over-ear headphones for sitting and listening. You'll get better sound and for cheaper, and then you don't have this damn battery thing you gotta worry about. But the truth is the AirPods Pro sound pretty damn good. They totally satisfy me for listening sessions, and if I'm really sitting listening to music, I'm not gonna use a fucking wireless Bluetooth headphone. But they do have a rich sound, they're easily pocketable, their battery's incredible, the microphonics aren't that bad, noise canceling on these doesn't have noise canceling, like, there's, okay, wow, that does a lot of things, it's like, but this is good when you're sitting and listening to music. Now, you might just want the best for the gym, look no further than the Power Beats Pro, which are excellent because they hook around the ear and they actually sound great for gym stuff, and they're super like water sweat resistant and stuff like that, but they're not pocketable at all. They're great for the purse and the gym bag if you just need a dedicated thing you want to keep in your bag. I don't really want to have multiple things. The AirPods Pro have an IPX4 water something, so you could sweat all over these, they're still gonna work great. You can drip water on them, is what IPX4 I think is. But, and it sounds good, and it stays put in my ear, it doesn't fly out, and they're so lightweight, and so I don't need these, right? Or you might wanna go for like the affordable option, like these Jabras, the 65T, it's like $120 right now, right? So you're at $110, $120 for the Cambridge Audio Melomania. You got the original AirPods at anywhere from like $100 to $150. And I wouldn't be surprised to see the price of those go down or something. But these are all three great options for when you, I don't wanna spend very much money, I just want something that works. The connectability on all of these is great. The sound quality of a call, like they do okay. Battery life's all solid, sounds all solid. So if you wanna do that, but it's like you pay an extra $100, and it's a smaller case than the Jabra, so more pocketable than some of them. It's definitely better sound than all of these. Definitely better qual quality than all these. Definitely better battery than all of these. So $100, you're gonna let $100 keep you from, like, that's just like, I just value my time and energy more than that. So in my experimenting, these AirPods Pro are legit and basically take the cake. I'm gonna walk you through all of these, don't worry. But my caveat here is I am in the Apple ecosystem. I've got a MacBook Pro recording my audio. I've got an iPhone Pro in my pocket, because apparently that's a thing now. I've got an iPad Pro that I do a lot of my notebooking and sketching in, right? The pairing of these things in that ecosystem, I don't have Android stuff to try out, is like easy. It immediately connects to the last thing it was connected to. If you want to connect to something else, you just go into Bluetooth, say AirPods Pro. It's already like knows that it's there and ready to be connected to it. So I'm constantly switching off between devices. That's connectivity. I don't know if you know this, but in these sorts of, if you're not all tech makes your life better. Sometimes it just makes it more complicated. Connectivity, multiple devices, is one of those things that can make your life a living hell, right? The Apple ecosystem, this is great. And by the way, all of these tend to do pretty well once you have your stuff set up. Like, you just have to know how to set the thing, put the things in the pairing mode, right? And then you gotta, you know, disconnect from other shit, and then you're connecting and you get it done. You get it done, but you know, again, that extra $100 is way worth it. They also have a solid sound, okay? An actually good sound. I'm gonna save to talk about the sound until we're talking about specific songs, okay? But they do have some dexterity, especially in their sub bass, the low lows, right? There's like a, it almost feels like there's a separate driver doing that stuff from this high stuff, because there's a lot of clarity throughout and you get really satisfying but clean sound, very clean, kind of, it's kind of, what's that word? On its way towards sterile, you know, towards more reference-y in some ways. There's definitely more presence. There's definitely a little more of that breath and that voice in those. You're gonna hear more of that, but there's a really satisfying, it feels like the bass is separated. Like, here's everything below 100 hertz, and then here's everything above that, and you get this beautiful dexterity. You get this fidelity in the sound there. And it's in your ears, so you're getting this like whole skull rumble kind of thing on those lows there. Now, these Sennheisers are way deeper, richer bass, while still having some great clarity and you know, fidelity up top. Really good, but low distortion, solid sound. I can use an EQ in the app to get, like, if I wanna flood myself out like that, but I don't need to. I like the sounds of these things. And then all the other lifestyle stuff about these, how pocketable they are, the battery, you've got like 24 hours of recharging in this case. Like, I think the buds are like 6 hours or 5.5 hours or something like that. They last really long, and they quick charge like this. This is wireless charger, so I just throw this on top of something like my OmniCharge here, and it starts charging. You see it charging already. Like, that's sick. So for me, that $250 is actually quite affordable because of all the things it gets me. Like, I'm not like running around like a, you know, expecting that Apple make this for $65 or something like that. And it feels like a fair price for the lifestyle that it enables for me. But I'm in the Apple ecosystem, so know that. Hear that all with a grain of sand, okay? Okay, so let me walk you through each one of these and explain a little bit more about which ones are which. I haven't even mentioned these Sonys yet, okay? Okay, first of all, we have the AirPods Old. All right, which are the original AirPods. They fall out of my ear. I have tried every kind of silicone tip, the ones with the wings and everything. The bummer is trying to find one that fits in the case still, because all your charging happens in the case. Long story short, I did not find one that would sit in my ears, and they all fall out. So, you know, just you should know in my testing that the sound mic quality on those is actually really solid. Those are beloved by the internet. These are like one of the world's best tech products, even though I've never used them successfully. The way that they connect, the, you know, decent sound and the way that it enables life and all that stuff. But that's all I have to say on these, because they fall out of my ears. Okay, then we have these Cambridge Audio Melomanias, which are super satisfying little bullets, right, that you put straight into your head. And these are one of my favorite simple, these ones were surprising. I remember getting these and being like, oh my God, they're so small and pocketable. One bummer is it's USB micro here. This just feels old. So everything, it's like, but it comes in at like $120, $130, something like that. They have decent battery life. They go in, they actually sound kind of good. They have these, you can use silicone tips or foam tips. I'm going with foam tips. And when you're getting it in, you kind of just twist it to get it right. And what's good about that, it just scrapes all the earwax. So you gotta clean them occasionally, but you get a great seal with the foam tips. You definitely feel them in there, but I like to have a quality seal. And once you get a good seal in there, they're actually pretty damn loud. So good loudness on there. Not that, like, you know, you're shoving something in your ear hole. So please don't turn it up too loud. This is one of the challenges with listening to music, especially when you're like listening a lot.
Now, sound-wise on this, I've got a playlist below that I'll link to, and I'll mention some songs off of that playlist. One of them is Anthropocene by Nick Mulvey, M-U-L-V-E-Y. I really like this guy. Writes very conscious music, but also like kind of a rambler. Nice thuds in the kick drum, nice plinks on a lot of like ukulele style, like smaller guitar plinking going on. And then there's this other song called TV Land. I can't remember the name of the band, but oh my God, it's so good. And this, these sounded surprisingly good. That's what these are known for, is they actually have a decent sound. So at $120-$130, this is one of those that I would recommend if you want pocketable. You can't go AirPods. It's more pocketable than the Jabra. I think these two are very competitive. The Jabra is $110 right now, and the Cambridge is like $130-$120, something like that. I actually prefer these just because the form factor is so much nicer. They connect decently. You got to go into pairing mode every time you're switching devices. They work pretty dang good. But the Jabra is very beloved on the internet. The Jabra is one that like people have been using as their daily driver for a really long time. So there's a lot of testing that have gone into this just by the internet at large. These are one of those Bluetooth earbuds that you can actually trust. So for $110, it's really trusty. Some of you are gonna love that. Myself personally, I definitely like the pocketability of this because this is just slightly too big to fit comfortably in my jeans. They're a nice fit. They go in. None of these fall out of my ears, and except for maybe, you know, some like the Sennheiser and the Sonys can get a little bit wobbly, I guess. But these Jabras are actually like, you normally have to go into the app and like boost some of the bass, give a little bass going there because they're quite tinny. But once you get an EQ set up that you like for the kind of music you're listening to, it's satisfying sound. You can get a nice like immersive kind of sound, but it's not for like listening, you know, it's not for sitting around like listening to good music going like, oh, you know, what did Bon Iver do in his latest album? I have to listen to this. Ultimately, it's kind of messy, kind of a messy sound, a little bit of distortion in the bass and the low mids. And so you don't have that dexterity and that clarity that I get so easily with the AirPods and the Sennheisers. And I feel like the Melomania is maybe slightly like more fun to listen to. So that's for those of you who aren't just going to go like, I'm going to spend the money and get this. I've got a few recommendations at the end. I'm going to tell you exactly what I would recommend. The Jabra, the Melomania, and the AirPods are all like, that's your good, cheaper, sort of more affordable stuff that I've tested. Okay, let's talk about the AirPods Pro. First of all, you got this great little case. It's super pocketable. Second of all, these things go in really satisfying, little magnetic sort of thing in there. I don't find it hard to get them out and into my ears at all. Oftentimes when I pull them out of my ears, I get that little thing happening. So I have to do a little like push, a little push before I put them in because the silicone tips are really like, you know, silicone tips are made for toys, but they're really lightweight. This is one of the things about the AirPods, compared to all of these, the most lightweight, the most sturdy and in my ear, even though I can't feel them very easily. I actually want a bigger earbud. They only have three sizes on the earbud things. I want bigger. I want to feel a little more pressure. I want to feel a little more of a seal there. But here's the deal with the Bluetooth or the noise canceling, I can go into my app and I can just push hard on my volume thing here and I can set it to noise canceling. It does a good job of noise canceling, you guys. Like, I can barely feel these things in my ear, so I don't have like this really tight, soft, solid thing the way I can get with these Melomanias. But it's piping in a signal that cancels out the noise around me and it does a damn good job of it. Thanks, Apple. Another one of those moments where it's like the ecosystem's sick, man. This feels good. Like, this enables so much life. They're very loud. They have plenty of volume for me. Very loud and low distortion at that. When I'm listening critically to music, I find that with all of these buds, I've had to kind of boost them as high as they can go, right? I'm used to also these Sennheiser PXC550s, which I kind of, like when I'm listening in a loud environment, I'm kind of pumping it up quite loud. What? And these get quite loud. Now, like I was saying before, really solid sound without being too lean. They're bright, Okay, they have some nice clarity and presence. You're gonna get a lot of that brightness, but there is this definite noticeable quality of a very undistorted bass signal that's loud enough, like it's getting like backs of my head, like bones in the back of my head to rumble a little bit, right? It's all like certain songs that I listened to, there would be a lot, it would take a while for something bassy, like a drum to come in, and it's like a hand drum, and you just hear this like boom, boom. You'd hear it with a lot of fidelity. And I did have some stereo imaging. It was really fun to listen to music. I mean, you could just get lost listening to music on these, which is, to me, if you're listening to a good song that you like, right, you just need a headphone that gets you there, right? If you go on a walk, if you blow a little smoke, if you are, you know, listening to music, like, you don't have to, how many nights have I spent with friends with music just coming out of my freaking phone, and we're just having a blast? Talking and hanging out and catching up and getting all the details of each other's lives, like the music provides the background. Well, so much more so with these. You get this nice fidelity in the sound. I just love that I could hear with detail. I could hear the detail of things, right? Without it being too harsh or sibilant. You will definitely notice it has more of that sibilant presence thing going on than some of these others, like especially when I was comparing it back and forth with this one, which I'll talk to you about in a second. This one song, Television Land, you just have to get these headphones and listen to that song. So good. This other one, Salt Water for Strings. Again, I'm linking to all these below. Really luscious, rich, good. It was more luscious on these, but one and done. You cannot walk around with these. The microphonics are so bad. You cannot trust that the battery is going to be there charged for you unless you're charging it every day, you know? Bon Iver song, Salem. By the way, that new Bon Iver album is wild. It's like only for listening by yourself. There's some good moments there. And in the Salem song, there's some good moments. And one of the things that's so gorgeous on these is the thud of the kick drum. You get this, you know, kick drum has all of this impact, this attack up front, and you have all this like click and stuff. I mean, Pantera, the drummer for Pantera used to have, you know, RIP Dimebag, but like used to have, like he would, it was an electronic trigger that was on his kick drum, and it's just the sound of like, it's the kick drum is so lovely in this Salem song, is all I'm getting to. It produced all that deep, rich bass, that almost sub bassy thud with clarity through those low mids and all of that presence up top in that attack. Thanks, Apple. And when I'm not talking about them, I'm just gonna put them over here so they can charge wirelessly on my OmniCharge. Thanks, OmniCharge! Okay, definitely some of the music became more alive with these, more immersive. It was just more just luscious. I was more surrounded by it. I couldn't, with the Sonys, I would have to like try to lean in to listen to it and to go like, okay, I can kind of get lost in this. With this, it was like I was lost really easily. And then comparing it to the AirPods was what was fascinating to me, because it basically just has more of this full skull like fill, especially in the low ends. But like in that Bon Iver song, Salem, at around 2 minutes 25 seconds, there's just all this weird, interesting detail that comes in still with these. Even though they're filling my head with this big, floody bass, there's still dexterity in it. Right? Which to me is the thing that gets me. Like, I hate it. I hate it. Like, these power beats, we'll get into that in a second. I don't like it when I can tell the distortion's happening. You know, like, and I'm like, oh, there's more clarity in this song than this is showing me. I know for a fact I just heard it on these other headphones, right? I don't like it when stuff's being hidden from me. It gets hidden from us because we're asking these little tiny speakers to do a fuck ton of work for us, trying to produce all these different kinds of sound waves, trying to reproduce, like, and to do it in one ear and the other. It's this fascinating little challenge which is one of the reasons why I love these so much. I think they're such a great product, the AirPods, because it's like, this is Apple going like, we have access to both ear canals. We can isolate everything we want. We just need to reproduce the sound. I mean, I don't know if you've learned much about how sound is reproduced, but it's wizardry, man. It's so, talk about wizards. So on that Bon Iver Salem song, 2 minutes, 25 seconds in, there's this like detail in these acoustic guitar-y, like ukulele type instruments with all of this other stuff going on. Nice super satisfying thud on the kick drum. But tons of microphonics, tons of like those things where if you create a seal in your ear and you step, you can hear like the vibration of your bones and your body all the way up. So it just ruins listening to music in that way. You can get through it though. If you get like, if you try to get like a lighter seal and walk, like they're decent for listening to podcasts and stuff like that. Because most of the time in my life, I'm using this stuff to listen to podcasts and audiobooks. I have to admit that. But I want it to be like when I'm on an airplane, you know, like when you're flying into a place, like you're flying into a place by yourself, you gotta have a good playlist for that time. I've got several. I'll link to below in the description below right now, where the plane is flying, sunset, you know, you want to have some good music to be able to like, and to be able to kind of get lost in the sort of reverie of it. I, you know, it's really lovely to do so. Those AirPods can do it. These Sennheisers can do it. But we have the additional bummer of the battery on this. The battery trickles down, okay? It doesn't have a great battery from the beginning. I mean, these like far outpace this by a long shot. Now, when I went from these over to these, I definitely noticed more presence, more of that upper mids that was prominent here. What I did is in Spotify, I went and I just did a little bit of bass boost, just a straight line lifting up the bass frequencies. And it got me closer to that flooding my skull kind of feeling with that Bon Iver Salem song, as well as that Saltwater String song, where there's these huge, beautiful, rich pads. But at first I did notice tons of clarity, could adjust that. But the truth is, if I'm listening to these, I just get used to that. I needed to boost that EQ just because over here, this was like, whoa, this was so much more in that low end, like richness, right? And I don't mean, when I say richness, I'm not saying clarity necessarily. These happen to be pretty clear. They happen to have quite a bit of clarity. Whereas these have a lot of richness in the bass, but not clarity. So it's not richness, it's just volume, right? And I gotta admit, there was definitely a little less clarity in the stereo image on the AirPods, okay? Just know that to be the case, that we're getting an everyday rambler who happens to be like, this is quite good at listening to music too. And that these are like, dude, in a very small package, if you didn't wanna carry around something that was bigger, in a very small package, as long as you keep it charged, you can have a really, really immersive, rich listening experience on a bus, on a plane, doesn't do noise canceling, right? So you can sit at a park and you're really gonna be sitting, you don't wanna be walking, right? So these are really complicated. These are really complicated, but like for those, you know, lonely rich dudes in Porsches who, you know, are sitting at a park somewhere eating a sandwich. Like that guy's, if he's wearing these, he might be just a fucking baller. Like going like, here's what I've learned. I listen to music for 35 minutes every other day or every day or something like that on my lunch break. And I just get immersed in some beautiful music that I love. You can get pretty close with these. So you just got to make sure that you keep them charged up. And when you're listening to them, you're sitting. So these were so good that I ended up not only testing it against the AirPods Pro. And I feel really good about my choice over here, sticking with those. Even though these were good, then I was like, well, what about comparing it to my PXE550s, which are my daily Rambler headphone for like editing videos. I just plug in, I can charge by the USB micro thing. I can like, everybody goes nuts for the Sonys, the WX, we're gonna talk about the WF or whatever. I hate the way that Sony names their products. I viscerally dislike it. But these PXE550s are still my daily driver for this stuff. They fit really well. They're so affordable. They've got a great touchpad for controlling music and stuff. Now I don't use the, I do my editing and my videos on this. I do my like, so these have just gotten like progressively more as I've started using these more off the side. But I've like, what does it sound like compared to these? Sounds decent. Definitely lacks some sparkle. This is excellent for your flights, for your travel, for your like, I'm on an airplane for 16 hours going to Vietnam and that's where these come in handy. So they were much more comfortable than these because these that go straight into your ear, you got to get a good fit, can be kind of challenging to get a good fit. Once they're in, they're pretty good, but these were much more comfortable and I had to boost the volume. I was like up at max volume for this, but I got most of the way there to a satisfying listening environment.
what more can you ask for in modern life? You know what I mean? It's like, hey, what are you gonna do? You know what I mean? Are you gonna do this? Or are you gonna do that? Well, I'll do that. You know what I mean? You do one or the other, it's like, yeah, it's fine. Both are favorites.
You're definitely gonna notice some pressure in the ear canal with these if you're getting a good seal, but I like that personally. You know, I like that person. We're gonna talk more about that in a second when I talk about these campfire audio, like badass IEMs. Okay, so then we've got the Sonys, all right? But first, this message is brought to you by Tech Pouches. Got some dirt in there. Do you know about Tech Pouches? Let me show you one. If you don't know about Tech Pouches, you gotta get them in your life. Here's a brand new one from Bellroy here. This is how I have it set up. Listen. Everything I need when I get out of when I get to the cafe, I've got my laptop and I've got this. In here, I've got my hard drive, my charger, I've got any cable I'm gonna need, my adapters if I need to pull in a camera card, like an SD card or something, and it fits in a pretty damn stylish little, like discreet little package. This is actually dope. This one's from Bellroy. But there's other tech pouches, like this Manal one. I'm gonna link to all these below. This episode is brought to you by Tech Pouches. This Manal one, you can get actual separators that you can separate your stuff, and then you've got a mesh in the front, and then there's a divider, and then there's more place in the back to put stuff, which is great. So I can have stuff I literally don't see, but I have it in case I need it, which is really the goal of a good tech pouch. This one from Velomaki is epic to me because it's super simple. They're a motorcycle company, and this is made to be like in a bag to be protected when your bag falls off your motorcycle or something. Just simple pouches back here, elastic up front, same on this side, and then about an inch of dimension all the way around. So it's all so easy to fit my headphones in. This is the one that I was doing for a long time, putting just my headphones in, and then everything else was like kind of fitting around those. Great way to carry bigger headphones when I wasn't just totally sold out for these little guys on a regular basis. So that's the Velomaki, and then finally the Peak design, which is like a modern work of modern art. It accordions open like this. I use this nonstop for all sorts of production gear stuff, all my cords and cables. These are the Sony in-ear things, you know? The tips, you know, I'm using words. They're words, they're English words. I'm a human person, I speak. The ear tips that go on those, I keep all that kind of stuff in something like this. So this episode has been brought to you by Tech Pouches. You can find links below when you click those links, and if you purchase anything, you support this channel because none of these companies sent me this shit. I'm not one of those like big reviewer guys. And this one was like a labor of love. So if you buy some of those, it's like buying me a beer maybe. And then also, you know, I'll tell you about how you can, you can go to Matterful.co. I got all my recommendations there for bags and shit too. Let's get back into the video. Okay, these Sonys are actually lovely little case, very dignified little product. I find that pulling them out of here, because I use the foam ear tip. Oh my God, and the foam just came out for the first time. It's never done that before. But I find that getting them in and out is a little bit of a bummer. And then getting the fit is a little bit of a bummer. Comparing that to the AirPods, where they're just straight in. But very dignified and good looking thing. Let's talk about the sound. I actually heard some stuff on these that I didn't hear previously. Once I heard it, I could go back and I could find them on the AirPods or whatever. But there were these metal clangs in one of the, I think the Bon Iver Salem song maybe, that was, cause it's thinner. It's definitely got some thinner sound, but nice clarity. So I found that in their app, I needed to go and turn up a little bit of the bass. There's a handful of EQ things you can choose from. Excited or Exciter sounded interesting, but it sounded like it just had like a loudness curve on. And then Bass Boost sounded good. So, you know, you've got some ways to control these things there in the app, including adjusting how much noise cancellation's going on. But ultimately, like, I'm not a huge fan of having an app to tune. Like, I just want this to all be bam, 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 right here, like right in here. The good thing is you can't really adjust EQ from there. So, you know, but you can adjust EQ inside Spotify or inside of Apple Music, I'm sure as well. So that's where I would do the EQ, I think. But doing the EQ in the app itself for these headphones is nice because then you're just adjusting the sound when you're playing through these headphones, which is a little more accurate. So maybe I should just, you know, get used to the apps. But overall, the sound was not quite satisfying. Like, I had to lean in quite a bit. It was there. First of all, like, these are great. Like, you'd be stoked. Just not quite as rich as the Sennheisers or the AirPods in their own way. Like, in the AirPods, they're rich. They're rich in dexterity too. Like so much separation, so much clarity between the frequencies. I love hearing the way it reproduces little like cymbal hits or drum taps or different weird acoustic instruments. So I went back and forth between these two and I noticed that the sub bass, so the really low stuff sounded great here. It's like nice and tasty. It was good. That was lacking over here. I also noticed that these had less microphonics than these. I'm using a foam tip on mine. You can use silicone if you'd like. Maybe you'd get a little less microphonics than the silicone tip, but you would potentially lose out on some of the seal. You know, it's the worst thing when if any of these like start coming out and getting loose. That's part of why I think I like, you know, everybody's ear canal is so different. And I've always had a problem with these damn Apple ones. And I want one size larger on the earbuds over here on the silicone tips, but there are going to be third party manufacturers of that stuff. If you're a third party manufacturer of some of those, get in touch with my people and send me everything. Cause I want to try it all. So overall sound quality wise, I actually preferred these, that Saltwater String Song. There's this really luscious filled bass thing. So much more satisfying over here. The thud in the kick drum in that Salem song. So much more satisfying over here. And it's pocketable, and the battery life's better than these, and the noise canceling is, I don't know, it's hard to compare the noise. They both work great. The noise canceling over here is solid, but because everything else is outperformed over here for, like, I think the same price or cheaper, maybe it is a little more expensive. I can't remember now. But even if it is a little more expensive, for all the features, I'm always looking at what's the best. I want to spend that money one time. I do not want to be back here watching another video realizing that there's another product I didn't know about that would have fit my needs more. You know, like, gosh, shout out to any of you who are in that boat right now. Oh well, opportunity cost is one thing, and then sunk costs is another thing, and we just gotta like, hey, acknowledge and move on. Acknowledge and move on. We all make mistakes, and that's not even that much of a, it's not even a mistake. It doesn't qualify. It's just there's so much information to know out there. How are you supposed to you really think you're gonna know it all? No, man, like I've watched a bunch of reviews on this stuff to try to get a sense of like, what am I looking at? What are we paying attention to? And you can't know everything all your own, right? You can't know everything all your own. We're in this together, especially when there's this many companies competing to make something that we are gonna buy. That's a good place to be. That's a buyer's market. Okay, finally, these Powerbeats Pro. Here's the deal. Great for the gym. Good sound, like, you know, bassy thing, but not a lot of detail. Not a lot of, plenty of, actually, there's some decent clarity, but the low-mid distortion, you just don't listen for it. And you'll be satisfied, you'll be happy. But if you're doing this critical listening bullshit, like it just ruins everything. It totally does. But these are so large that you're gonna need, they're gonna go in the gym bag or in the purse or in the tech pouch maybe or something like that. These are not at all what I would choose for my daily rambler. It would just be for that purpose-driven sort of thing. For some of you, that's right in the money because you're like, I just wanna have that in the bag. I don't wanna have to worry about it. And I wanna like, you know, you plug it into like a battery in your gym bag, and then every week you charge that battery up or something like that. That would be a good way to go, but you know, spendy. By the way, call quality on these is really good. That's interesting. I did a bunch of tests on these. Call quality was one of them. The AirPods sound great. Both the AirPods sound solid. These ones all sound the best. The Apple ones all sound the best. The Sennheisers sound worthless. They're really bad microphone. The Sonys are pretty good, but it seems like it's doing a lot of like noise. It's trying really hard to get your voice. So if you're not quite loud enough in the soundscape, or if you're, it can sound like really like dithered and funky, robotic in some ways, but it works. Same thing with the Jabra and the Cambridge. They work. Actually, the Cambridge did, I thought this would be the worst, and it ends up doing pretty, like, these are solid. These are two are solid. These are all excellent. So again, the AirPods winning there. But this is not a listening headphone. This is just for working out. Okay, now listen, these Campfire Audios, I've got to find a way to get them back to headphones.com. They sent me a handful of really high quality headphones, and I think I made them a little upset, and I have to apologize, Andrew and the crew, because I was used to just like testing gear that like I was throwing around a bit, and I think I threw around their $4,000 headphones a little too much. But I did listen to the shit out of those things and put them through their paces, and I'll link to both of those below. I have, well, there's a handful. There's the Focal Utopias, which were excellent, and then there's the LCD 4 from Odyssey. But anyways, something else that came back then were these Campfire Audio headphones. They're in-ear monitors. They go really deep in there. It's a fucking pain in the ass to get a good seal. You're getting really fussy about your ear tips and shit like that. So in all of this, I was like, well, you can bring this. It doesn't charge. Doesn't need a battery. You just got it. You plug it in. You could use it on your laptop. You can use it on any device, as long as you have a little, you know, adapter to plug it into your phone or whatever. What do these really compare from in a listening environment, like actually listening? And honestly, it took me a little while because they're much more reference-y. They're much thinner sounding at first. They don't have this wow in the bass and stuff. But as you work to get a better seal, then you find this like, oh, it was really, really fun to listen to these songs on these headphones. Really rich bass once you get down out of this tier and into like your ears kind of like getting used to it. They normalize to what you're listening to. They're a reference device. Your ears are constantly referencing what it sounds like compared to what it sounded like before. You're making changes. So we're really good at adjusting and paying attention to different sounds or whatever, right? These sounded really good once I got used to them, but it took a while, and they're really fussy to get it. In-ear monitors can be so fussy to get a good seal, but it was all there. This is a $499, like a $500 headphone, Campfire Audio, their Polaris. And I don't know if this was number one or number two. I can't remember because I've had these for a while, but they really had some dexterity. So do me a favor and go click that link to headphones.com at the time code right now. Thanks, Andrew and headphones.com people. Let's do some more work together. I love doing headphones and listening to music. You know what I mean? Then I also got these a while ago. Have you seen these? They're like, everything is these are totally like, you can take them off. They're different drivers. Everything is replaceable on these. They look kind of dope. Their marketing's excellent. It's comfortable, great fit. A little like jiggly because of the way that we're doing this right here. But once you're on, you don't notice that. So I wanted to see like, what these sound like listening in this. It's been so long since I've been in a critical listening environment. You know, mostly listening on a Bluetooth headphone or Bluetooth speakers while I'm like entertaining some big party, you know? And these sounded awesome. I don't know, I'll put a link to these below. I don't remember what the price is right now, but they sounded great. Like if you're thinking about going with the Sennheisers, go for like a pair of headphones like this. There's something kind of adolescent about the sound. By the way, there's different drivers you can get for these. And so you can like change out the drivers depending on what you want to be listening to. But I'll link to exactly what I have in here. I don't remember which ones I have in here. They definitely had dexterity. They definitely had clarity. They definitely had fidelity, right? But there was something kind of adolescent about the sound signature itself, right? A little bit of a loudness curve maybe going on, but they didn't do that distortion around the low mids, the high bass stuff. There was some seriously good shit going on. Especially in that Salem song by Bon Iver. I was like, it was sort of distracting. It was sort of all over the place. It felt like this was like, it felt like it was a race car trying to like, you know, drive on the streets or something like that. Not a perfect metaphor, but it was close enough. So then I put on this Paul Simon song, Hearts and Bones, because it was much more subdued, much more chill. And man, it sounded so good. These are totally worthy for just like sitting and listening. But if you're gonna do that, you might as well like do a little research and find what the bet, like you might be in the Sennheiser, the HD something something. So that's the video that I wanna make with headphones.com next. It's like, what's the best desk headphone? You know, that you're at the desk, you need three kinds of headphones. You need something on the go that's small and pocketable if you can. You need a desk headphone, right? Where you're at, you're just sitting, you're listening. Something, this is where you can do your critical listening. It's also where you're just like working on the computer, like YouTube videos, all sorts of stuff. So comfortable, open sound, sounds great. Then the third one, if you really want to, is just like your backup pair in case all your batteries die, right? A corded pair that like you're 12 hours into an 18 hour flight and you're like, luckily with these, there's quick charge. So within like 10 or 15 minutes, you've got an hour and a half, or maybe I think it might be 3 hours of listening. So like 10 minutes to an hour and a half, it's like you take 10 minutes, you charge the thing. So maybe you don't even need this thing at all with these. If you've got, you know, a battery that can charge it up. Another song I listened to on these, just the final note here, is that I was listening to Hearts and Bones, Paul Simon, and then I went to my favorite Paul Simon album, which is Rhythm of the Saints. I might be weird. Most people are Graceland or like other shit like that. Man, Rhythm of the Saints is just my jam. Like, and I know a few people who like have the same feeling. It's just like all that drumming, all the percussion, all the way that was recorded. I just think it's gorgeous. And speaking of batteries here, this is that little anchor one that I'll mention here just because it might be perfect for a lot of, I keep a bunch of little cables in here. Why? Because I've got two plugs here, a USB-A and a USB-C. USB-C charges really fast. It charges my phone really fast. It charges these AirPods really fast. So if I got a USB-C to Lightning or a USB-C to USB Micro or USB-C to USB-C to charge my iPad, or I don't think I can get anywhere on my laptop with this thing. What's great about having one of these, it's so small. I'll link to my favorite small one. Just in a little pouch like this with all the things, it's just my little first aid kit in case you need it, right? So, thanks, Anchor. So I'm obviously recommending the AirPods Pro personally for most people just because that's the one that I'm using. Like, I've been really, really, really hard on all of these, testing things out and trying shit out. And it's like, you know what? These solves all my problems. They do it really well. I'm glad I got to do all that critical audio testing too and the microphone testing. These things just work super good. Pocketable, great battery, all that stuff. So it might be more than what you're thinking, but this is where I would go. The more affordable option, I'd say you're going between, you know, I'll include the original AirPods in this as well, but the Jabra and the Melomania. Powerbeats for the gym only and for phone calls, right? They're great, great sounding microphone for phone calls. Battery's great, but it's massive. You can't pocket this thing. So it's like gym only. Sennheisers for mobile sitting listening. If you're just like, you wanna be that lonely Porsche driver on the park bench eating a sandwich, listening to, you know, Steely Dan, this is where you are. This would like, you can get these just to become that guy, like for a Halloween costume or something, because it's really satisfying to do that. But you're not moving around, you don't wanna take calls with these, like maybe just emergencies. You're probably gonna have these in your pocket and this in your bag. You know, then you're like, you might be being a little too fussy, because you can get that same sound by boosting some EQ stuff, right? And you've got a lot of detail and clarity and actual, you know, fidelity listening there, which does not justify its own purchase. I would much rather you go for a pair of good sitting headphones and actually when you sit and listen to music, like sit and listen to music, and then everything else is on these. So that means in my bag, typically, if I'm doing a lot of editing and I wanna do the over ear, if I'm traveling, I'm bringing these and these. That's what I'm rocking right now. What do you got? What are you using? What are the results? How are you liking it? Let me know in the comments below. I wanna hear what you're using. Maybe it's something different. All right, so that's my take right now, all right? The truth is you don't need any of this shit. What you need is, well, what do you need oxygen. And you probably need to masturbate at some point. Just because you get funky, it's like, you know, yeah, you're not yourself when you're hungry. You know what I mean? But your dollar is your vote. You don't need to hire any of these things for any of that. You can totally go through life without any of this. I like personally though the lifestyle that this enables, the humanity, the dignity of taking calls, talking to my dad, talking to my mom, talking to my friends, but then walking, listening to podcasts, taking fucking Duncan Trussell with me everywhere I go. Duncan Trussell is a podcaster. He's super weird. I fucking love him. Shout out to Duncan or Joe Rogan, right? Or Liz Gilbert. Go listen to old Liz Gilbert episodes of her Big Magic podcast. It's really good for you. Any of you creative folks, go treat it like a course. Just go listen to all the big, what is her podcast called? I'll link to it below. Right? So for listening to stuff like that, I feel like it bumps my life up a notch. Like it's nice to go on a walk solo, get into nature. That's the best. bring all your, but you got to do that for a while to really get your energy down, right? Instead, I can just take a, you know, 30-minute stroll, get in a podcast at, you know, 1.5-2 times speed, and it's like, it's invigorating. I come back, I'm ready to jump into work. Hey, I just released my gift guide, by the way, for the holidays. There's a lot of ideas in there for you and for other people, right? So make sure your partner knows about it. Make sure your family knows about it. Hey, here's some good ideas for me. And then also, it's a great place for you to go find some ideas for other people, I think. I'm trying hard. Comments below on anything that should be added to the gift list that's like your favorite, you know, gifts you've ever gotten, right? Then while you're there at the gift guide, at the very bottom of every page on Matterful, which is my website where I catalog and create and organize all my recommendations of shit, is the email list. Getting on the email list is how you enter to win free shit. Here's the deal. I don't send emails almost ever, okay? You're not gonna get spammed from me. I have to have your email address so I can tell, so I can write back and go like, hey, you won. Where's the address I'm getting someone like Peak Design or Boundary Supply to send you your free bag to? Because we're gonna give away thousands of dollars worth of gear, okay? We're just about to pass 75,000 subs. That's about to happen, so make sure you're on the email list there. We'll also do some of the giveaways on Instagram, I think. So if you're not following there, I'll link to Instagram below right now. Okay, y'all, that's it. That's the headphone earbud. Do you know how long I've been waiting to do this fucking video? I hope you got what you wanted out of it. I hope it helps you make a decision. I hope it helps you get out of this conversation. There's just too much interesting shit going on in life. There's too many people to talk to and too much stuff to make to be really spending time thinking about what fucking wireless earbud should I get? You know what I mean? Back to your regularly scheduled programming, back to life, back to creativity, back to making something, back to screaming into the void, you know, against your own despair, right? Kicking at the indifference until it bleeds life, as my friend Dan would say, or just like hovering by the void going like far out, man. We do not know what we're doing here. Our existential dilemmas are we all have an existential crisis now, right? You know the feeling. If you don't, you will. Because it's kind of weird to be on this rock and spinning around and just, and like getting a job and for me making video, like coming up with an idea of a video, like I got to imagine you. I got to think who you are out there. It's like sometimes you can get really in your head when you're doing creative work. And some of you really want to be doing creative work, right? You really want to be doing creative work instead of, you know, pushing paper around a desk and doing whatever bullshit that you're doing, if you're doing a bullshit job. And others of you, like, we need your voice to tell us that there are good jobs out there. Right? Companies that support and encourage you, companies that are humane and that are working for the world and the environment. Like Peak Design just did this great, interesting launch of this new label that they want to get companies adopting. Like there's a label called like 1% for the planet. And if a company is subscribing to that, they put that label on their tags. When you buy it, you see it and you know that they're giving 1% of all their proceeds back to the planet or whatever. Well, this one is for, you know, them coming to the table for doing what's necessary to offset their carbon footprint, right? It's a label for that. There are some companies that are really humane, really dignified, really, really sustainably oriented. Bellroy is another one. Pact, the duffel bag that the company that I'm building a travel backpack with right now. Right now, our main material looks like it's going to be a water bottle recycled material because of just that story is just too big. It's just too good. And the material performs great, but it's like, if we can turn literal water bottles from the sea into a material that we can weave fabrics out of and make stuff. I mean, I think this one from Bellroy might even be made out of. I know some of them are. It's just some companies have these values and others don't, right? Some companies are just entrepreneurs, just like, I'm gonna try to figure something out, man. Woo! We're gonna do it, right? This opportunistic sort of, we've all been there in life. Have you ever been so hungry that you like just dished up before everybody was ready, right? You know this feeling, right? Of like, I gotta solve this problem. And a lot of companies are operating out of that. And I think a lot of creatives can operate out of that. And what we're really wanting is maturity and development of our creatives, you know, to run the fucking world, man. To run the fucking world. Because this whole goddamn world is creative. You know, the business and the accounting and all that stuff is so that we can keep being creative, right? We can keep making things. But so much of, if you are one of these people who wants to be a creative and you're not right now, so much of your deal is, I should not be doing a big old ramble right now, but I guess we're in this. I guess here we are. Because this video is going to be long enough as it is. So much of the challenge is in our, have you heard this term ego? Ego is like, now it's like du rejour. Everybody knows about ego. It's like, oh yeah, I'm all, like, we're like, you don't have to have a spiritual practice to be like, you know, oh, it's, I'm just being so in my ego recently, or my ego's just in the way, or the ego is the enemy, right? The thing about creative work is it gets really messy how your ego gets attached to this, to these projects and to these. Because your ego is your, is kind of, it's somewhat related, it's related to your sense of self. And it's like, hey, if I make this, then they'll think I'm like that, right? That's where you really want to get in with tweezers and like remove that thing that's stuck in your foot, right? And you got to get into like, hold on, I'm making this, like I'm making the thing I want to see in the world, right? And if nobody comes to it, if nobody sees it, if it doesn't solve anybody's problem ever, no bad, whatever. I'm mostly right now interested in just, can I make this? Can I do it to a level that satisfies me, right? Get really selfish in your creativity. For some of you, that's actually really bad advice. For some of you, it's great advice. And I'm only talking in this one frame to all of you. So I guess we'll save that for Matterful Camp at some point. I would really like to do that. Get a bunch of you together. Let's all get together and go to camp. And I can split you up into like, all right, you people, you need to think about this side of creativity. You people, you need to think about that side and do practices related to those. All right, what am I talking about now? All I know is that a lot of you want to be doing creative, independent work. And that's what I've been teaching people how to do for almost a decade at this point. And man, it's complicated. It's complex. Some of this tech doesn't actually make your life easier. It just makes it more complex. And I am craving making life more simple right now. And you can do that with creative work. You can get really simple about it. You're gonna have to remove some of this like messy, sinewy ego stuff that attaches, and you have these like tendrils that are connecting to it, like you're like my precious about it. Okay, if that's relevant to you, you gotta say so in the comments, because otherwise I'm just talking to the wind. I can't imagine, most of these people watching this are just like, I just wanted to watch a fucking video to see which one of these I should get. Why are we talking about Smeagol? All right, y'all, talk to you later. Thanks for watching. Subscribe here. Remember the email list at Matterful and the gift guide. I'll link to both of those below. Holler at your boy. Make sure he doesn't play in the street. Bye-bye.